This is Business for Breakfast.
8:22 here on Money Radio 1200. I'm Jeffrey O'Brien.
And I'm Francoise Rose. The Dow is down 47 points. NASDAQ down 48. S&P 500 is down 12.
And in the futures, they are down 28. Corn is down 1. Gold is up $9 an ounce. And oil is hanging in at $97 a barrel this morning. All right, let's get right to it. We're going to do a little ethics watch here. All the stuff that's going on. We got the worries and the concerns about Target, Neiman Marcus, and Michaels with credit card theft and information. And privacy is becoming more and more of a big issue. And here to talk to us about it this morning is Dr. Adriana Sanford. She's a professor to over 1,600 MBA and undergraduate students at the W.P. Carey School of Business at Arizona State University. Good morning, Dr. Sanford.
Good morning.
When it comes to our private information, now, the first thing that struck me is, well, why are they holding on to my information? They got my money. Well, why are they holding on to all this different information, and what are they using it for? I mean, are they using it for the marketing? Or are they using it just to keep track? I mean, when is it okay for them to disclose or even gather or keep this information? When is it not?
Well, it depends on the way they're accessing the information. Is there some kind of a consent being given by the consumer? Is the consumer aware of it? And who are they giving this information to? Are they keeping it for themselves, or are they giving it to a third party?
Yeah, I guess I don't mind when they keep some information on me to market to me. I don't like it when companies sell the information to third parties. There's really no way to stop them, is there? I mean, is there something you can do? And unless they give you the option to check a box on a piece of paper, you're pretty much at their mercy, right?
Well, again, it depends on how this information is being accessed. If they're taking it from websites, you know, looking at what websites you're visiting, through these web bugs or through cookies, or are they getting the information from your credit card purchases or your magazine subscriptions? There's really nothing you can do about that right now, unfortunately.
They're trying to do a better job, they say, of giving consumers what they need. And as a shareholder, you know, they're just trying to do a better job of reaching customers and making money.
Well, the question is, have they gone too far? And are they taking the steps necessary to protect that information and make sure it's not being violated? The biggest concern I think people have right now is the hacking. And companies are struggling to try to make sure that that does not happen because it affects their reputation. So the big issue for companies right now, and whether or not they've gone too far, is who is getting this information, how is it being accessed, for what reasons, and by whom? And do we have the means within our company to protect our customers, our clients, from hacking? There are steps that companies can take to try to protect their privacy. And when we're talking about privacy, there's different levels of privacy. We have trade secrets and formulas, like the Koeck formula. And we have customer lists. And then we have customer information. All these things need to be protected. And there are solutions that can help companies, such as IBM and Microsoft. IBM has the Enterprise Privacy Authorization Language. Microsoft has what's called Next Generation Secure Computing Base. But these, what they do is they keep an eye out for what is being accessed. You have this program, and it will tell you who is getting this information, how is it being accessed, for what reasons, and by whom.
I kind of feel like if a company wants to hold some information on me for marketing purposes, I'm okay with that. But when they hold my financial information and that is at risk, that bothers me. It also bothers me when they sell my information to somebody else. And I don't blame Target or Neiman Marcus or Michaels. They got hacked. It's not like they wanted to be, but they did. And I know that there needs to be some increased security to protect our information. Talk to us about their obligations in disclosing these things.
The issue is between disclosure and privacy. Where is the line? With regards to selling your information or giving it, obviously we need disclosure. If a company has been hacked, like Target, like Neiman Marcus, like Michaels, disclosure is very important. Privacy should not take precedence over disclosure because we need to protect these consumers. We need to protect the public and make sure that they take the proper steps to close those accounts to protect themselves from identity theft. And in that case, disclosure obviously should take precedence over privacy.
All right. And well, in that case, if disclosure should be trumping privacy, like when these companies, you know, get hit, do we need a law to make companies like Visa disclose that these are the people who have been hit? These are the companies that you may be having to look for on your credit card statement? Because a lot of times these big companies, when they do get hit, you don't find out about it for quite some time. They withhold that information that could protect you.
The laws are currently being developed. developed. They are changing. I'll give you an example with regards to counterfeiting of products. Before, many companies would stay quiet. They did not want to lose their market. They did not want the counterfeit product to hurt their reputation. The laws have changed. Today, if a company knows that their product is being counterfeited and there is a safety risk associated with this, the laws have said that if a company does not disclose this and does not warn the public, they will be liable if the public gets hurt. So we are taking steps to change the laws, to make it better, to make companies more responsible with regards to these types of issues. And it continues to evolve. Just like our technology is evolving, All of this is coming together. All of this is evolving at the same time.
It needs to evolve quicker, and they need to respond faster because our wallets are at risk. Dr. Adriana Sanford from the W.P. Carey School of Business, Arizona State University, thanks so much for being with us for Ethics Watch. We'll be back with Lauren DeSarto from Desert Health Magazine. Going to talk about heart health right here on Money Radio 1200.